Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Today, we'll see a team that can get it done on the ground. The Titans are top 10 in rushing TDs, and they'll go up against the Jags defense that needs to be ready for that. Set for the call of this Week 15 matchup, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you, Larry. We welcome everyone to the Music City, just a stone's throw from the Country Music Hall of Fame. We are at Nissan Stadium in Nashville, Tennessee. Today, we reach Week 15, and we've got a good matchup in store between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the Tennessee Titans. Jackson on the carry. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And if this offense is going to flow today, certainly the running back will be a key piece.
Without a doubt, because they asked their runner to not just do that, but to block, to catch, to help set a tone for their offense.
Four down, four down.
Now a second down throw for Mariota. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They were ready for what the defense was showing. They had prepared for that look, recognized it, went straight to the air, got the first. Well done.
Love the recognition, because you can prepare for everything. You can watch the tape and put together your game plan, but you still have to understand what they're doing in terms of what they're showing and be able to adjust accordingly, and they did exactly that.
And that'll be incomplete. And this Jacksonville Jaguar defense, Charles, they have a lot riding on the youngster Jalen Ramsey.
As you well know, he was my number one player coming out of the 2016 draft. I loved his versatility. The big question mark, is he enough of a ball hawk? Didn't have very many interceptions in college, but boy, he does everything else that you want. Runs, hits, wraps up on his tackles. He's going to start on the corner for the Jaguars.
Oh, he's got him in wide open, complete. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Jackson, and some room to work, and he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 11 yards on the pickup, and that'll be good for a Tennessee first.
And that run was what a lot of people called explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a two tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the two tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see two tight ends on the field, your first thought is to think run. In this case, the offense was able to run successfully. Not only did they drop what looked like an interception in the end zone, they blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. So the D-line's going to spread out. Now Mariota. And he comes back with one complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff.
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time. Really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
The run. This is Jackson, and he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack, and on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. They run again with Jackson. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
On third down, Mariota. Throwing middle, and it's complete. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. And Bullock will put this one through, and the Titans hit the scoreboard first. It's 3-0. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
It's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. And here's the offense today that hopes to get off to a strong start. Second and 5. Now a handoff here to his running back. And some space here. Cuts it out to the sideline. And all the way down to the 29. The defense came out with a look that they had prepped for all week to attack. They took advantage, got the first down.
And the key words in there, prepped for all week. They really studied them, understood their tendencies, knew what they liked to do, and prepared their game plan accordingly. And boy, the payoff was good.
And to the left side, Fedorowicz has it. They'll get 17 yards there, and it'll give the Jags a first down.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
And they'll go to the ground attack here. No, followed up. It's out, it's loose. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And here comes Tennessee as they get sent to take the field. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that one, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
Second down following the run. The play clock's running down. They just get the playoff. Now Mariota. And he will find his man on the outside. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
So here we go, 1st and 10 now. Mariota on 1st down. And that is incomplete. Second down here after the incomplete pass. Throwing again, Mariota on second and 10. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Miles Jack can just flat out cover. Doesn't matter who's out there, and he can do it really well in man. How about what he just did there in zone, though? Eyes in the right place, saw where the ball was going, reacted appropriately, and knocked it away.
So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. They come out here in the eye. To the air again, Mariota. Wide open receiver complete. And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, Titans. A big play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead. When they drew that up, I don't think they envisioned it ending in a house call. But he got him, took it all the way home.
Really impressive run after the catch, wasn't it? That was really special by him. But let's face it, in today's NFL, those tight ends are often former wide receivers or maybe even sometimes bigger running backs. They just put them in a position to get a great matchup and make plays like that.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And now out come the Jags. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, you have periods devoted in practice just for that because everyone knows how vital it is to put points on the board when you've entered that part of the field. And to come away with nothing, that's difficult for a team to handle.
And difficult, and now we'll see if they can make it less difficult on themselves on this drive. A look at the defensive starters for Tennessee.
Dante Hightower is a guy who can play the run with the best of anyone in the league, but he'll fool you a little bit in pass coverage. Not so bad there as well.
Here we go. 38.
Back to throw now on second and 10. Right side caught Fedorowicz. Give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
Come on, let's go! White,
and they'll go on the ground. They find some open field here. And able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Alongside the former defensive back, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It's just... So we've got a second and five. They'll look to throw here. And the hook up here to Allen Robinson. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
Really nice connection on the corner route. This is a play where the receiver wants to set up the defensive back by moving him inside and then breaking back to the corner.
They run. Robinson. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there. Second down.
While there was no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window, and they've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
And a dump off here to Robinson. 6 yards on the pickup, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Here we go!
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive.
Come on, let's go.
The motion man is Tate. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
Let's go! 1, 9, 9.
Back to throw. But they'll say it's incomplete. Allen Robinson, the intended receiver. And now it's third down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. An 8-play drive to this point. So here's play number 9 on 3rd and 7. He'll drop to throw. And that is out of the back of the end zone, incomplete. C.J. Fedorowicz, the intended receiver, and it's 4th down. Now a field goal try coming up here for the Jags. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalposts, and they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. So he splits the uprights there, and I would imagine it's nice as a kicker. Right when it leaves your foot, you know it's good.
Yeah, it's kind of like a golfer that picks up his tee after a nice drive without even watching it land.
Solid analogy. I like it. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look foolish.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away. Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground. On the ground, this is Jackson. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll set up a 3rd down.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Oh, and the defender took some liberties there with a late hit, roughing the passer.
The league has done a great job of defining what is a late hit and illegal contact on a quarterback. The defenders really have to get in line.
And the offense lining up 1st and 10. First down, Mariota. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it's a 2nd down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Try the right side here. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it.
When the 4-3 defense is functioning really well, you know who stays what we call clean and no one gets to him? The guy playing the middle linebacker position. The guy we call Mike. That means the defensive front is eating up all the blocks and just let him go to the football and make a play.
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. They'll run it with Jackson. And he's going to have the 1st down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
On 3rd down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the 1st down marker was and getting there.
Fake here on 1st down. And he's gonna go down. They get to him back at the 40. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on 1st down on the sack.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
Mariota now on second down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. They got pressure there and only rushing three.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with three there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You dropped an eight. Where are you going to go with the football?
Third and long here for Mariota. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
This one will wind up being down just outside of that 20-yard line. And the returner has that invisible shield around him. He deserves that space. Didn't have it there. That's why the penalty comes out.
Awareness goes on both sides of the ball. The guys chasing it down have to know whether the ball is going to be caught, fair caught, whatever, so they don't contact the punt returner.
And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
One of the things that's really difficult for an offense is often identifying how to block a 3-4 defense. Well, when they're coming out of blitz, even more difficult. They're elusive targets and hard to hit.
Now back to throw. And his throw here is incomplete. Dime look defensively here for the Titans on third. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And Tate's got it. And he gets it down to the 48. Enough for the first. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
They'll run it now with Robinson. And he's brought down. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
And on the left side, Fedorowicz has it. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. Well, I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs, and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And Davis has it over the middle. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Here we go!
Back to throw here. His throw incomplete.
I know in every game we do, we talk about momentum. That was a momentum play lost. And now there could be a letdown because they didn't get the interception.
Yeah, you could almost hear the collective gasp on the sideline as he could not come up with that football. And on 3rd and 5, this will be the 8th play of the drive. They'll set up to throw. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. It'll be a 3-yard pickup, and it brings up 2nd and goal. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. And just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense.
Here we go! Ryan 38! Black Brown! Black Brown!
Now the backup, Boykin, his first throw. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
The good signal call is they never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
And now for the offense, this is play number 11 here on this drive. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. He loses 4, and it brings up 4. So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get 3 to end the first half. This is a 26-yard attempt. And Succop will put this one right through, but there is a penalty marker down. They might be forced to try this one again. So we've reached halftime here in Nashville. And pump the brakes, Larry. Pump the brakes. We are ready for quarter number 3. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Out come the Jaguars now as they'll go on offense first here in this 3rd quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. They're going to look to throw. Going for the deep ball. And they went for a big play through the air on 2nd down. Couldn't connect. Now it's 3rd.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. Back to throw. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
And that'll hit at the 5 and go into the end zone for a touchback. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
And how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. 2nd down and just 1. Time running out here on the play clock. They'll give it to him right up the gut. Through an opening, and there he goes. Touchdown, Titans. A great play there. His 4th touchdown on the year. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead. They blitzed defensively there, but he was able to slip through that first layer, and then he was gone.
I think they won the leverage game, didn't they?
Yes.
Right? They saw the blitz coming. That got to him a little bit, but they leveraged it perfectly and found not just a crease, a gigantic hole. And off he goes, and he's still going all the way to the end zone.
This will be taken about the 12. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Here comes the Jaguars offense as they get set here. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut it. So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Second down now after the pass completion. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And a cut to the left sideline. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to. But they didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either. Well played.
Yeah, and it created a big run. Now back to throw, and it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Second down now after the incompletion. A play fake as they set up to throw. He's going to wind up and air it out. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up. And they just did. And they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
So a ways to go here on 3rd and 10. Now a shotgun snap is nowhere to go. Here he lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. This is taken around the 12. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return, and it'll be Titans football. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counterpunch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got to a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. And they're going to go soft on the corners. Mariota now on 2nd down. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? Play clock winding down. And they'll run it here. And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. Give him 3 on 1st down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there. And it's been that way the entire game. not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Now they'll run it on the toss. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
Any team that runs the toss and runs it successfully, that means they win the battle on the edges. That means you seal the edge in order to let your back get to the corner. They got it done there for a very nice game.
On first down, they'll run it on the draw play. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Well, there was no blitz. That was just a draw play that, to be frank, didn't fool anybody.
Did we hear the entire stadium screaming draw? Because
they,
it felt like everybody was all
it.
Over that play, and the defense won that battle.
10 yards still left on second down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And here's another tackle made at the line. So they're converging well on the football now. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
Dante Fowler just made a play that he could be really proud of there. Nice tackle for loss. And what a relief it is for him to be back on an NFL field after missing his entire rookie season with a knee injury.
I think the entire defensive unit is relieved that he's out there. On third down, Mariota. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. The play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line giving them time to complete that first down pass.
And some changes here as the D-line separates some. They go play action here on first down. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Just 2 yards to go here on second down for the offense. They'll come out in the pistol. Again, we'll see the pistol here. And he stopped immediately there. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the left hash, this from 34. And Bullock will put this one through. And that will get the lead up to 14. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point. So no problems converting there.
This will be taken about the 12. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists.
And he's into the clear. The 20. Touchdown, Jaguars. A great effort there. His 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Jaguars are back within a score. Well called, well blocked, and then he just made a great play. That was an athlete going a long way.
Yeah, how about the suddenness, too, of just getting there and taking off and going? For the defensive guys, plays like that really hurt.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3 except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time it's end zone and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get 3, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Second down, Mariota. And he's got his man on the out route. Back now in Nashville. They come out here in the eye. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. Well, they'll take that every time with a lead, first down, fourth quarter, getting 8 yards. You love that.
They will take it, and you have to ask the defensive guys, why did you give it? I mean, you know the situation. You're down, have to stop them, have to get the football back. But 8 yards on first down puts them back on their heels.
And again, this time to the tailback. And this carry not as productive. He's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
He's going to get this one out to his fullback. And the play goes nowhere, losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way, lost yardage.
No, for some reason, it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you can move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized, executed well, and you caused a lost yardage play. That's going to feel good and look great in film.
And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are.
Whenever we meet with coaches and they always talk about wanting to establish running the football, it's oftentimes with a good tight end who can control the line of scrimmage and the point of attack, and they're becoming harder to find because the colleges are giving us a whole lot of receiving tight ends, former wide receivers who can run, not necessarily block very well. In this case, though, we saw two tight ends on the field, both of them with the ability to block, and he ran the ball successfully behind that power set. Love the call by the offensive coordinator, recognizing the situation very well, calling for the play-action pass, and completing it.
And he'll give it here to his running back. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. He's fumbled already once, Charles. I'm not going to say that that was in his mind there, but I'm sure that during some of these plays, he is mindful of it.
And once you fumble the ball, you know what your team tells you and your coaching staff? Take care of it. Rest of the game. And it does get in your mind a little bit, and sometimes that slows down your effort in trying to get free from tackles.
And the defenders know it, too. They sniff that out, don't they?
Everybody wants to swarm the football. You know the rule is, first guy hold up the runner, everyone else try and get there and strip the ball free. Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
Offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's going to go up top again. And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up fourth down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the one-yard line. Here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Very tough spot here for the offense to start. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And they'll get him down up past the 15. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
When a coaching staff sees their team run the ball this successfully in the fourth quarter, they're really excited, because you can plan for a running game all you want to press that advantage when you get it. But for the most part, it's a little bit of a surprise. And right now, they're going to keep that going, want to continue to grind out the clock, because it's definitely in their favor at this stage of the game. Can they close the game out and continue to do exactly what we just saw there, and that's run the football?
The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Now a handoff here to his running back. 3 yards on the gain. They're going to need to do better on this next play. It'll be 3rd and 12.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first-level run, and it was stopped by a second-level player.
So following the run, we'll see what they do here on third down. Mariota from the gun on third down. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Deshaun Gibson, and he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line. The Jaguars offense now heads back onto the field. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up. But you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving it, you're giving your defense a chance, because you're punting the ball away and they're set to go on the field, as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we've got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Back to throw here. And Davis has it over the middle. And they do get him down, but not before he reaches the 4-yard line.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well, because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
And the offense inside the 5 here at the 4. It's 1st and goal. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. No gain on the play there. It'll be 2nd down. Then he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, 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 and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Losing yardage to the 5. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up 3rd.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Now from back at the 5, this is 3rd and goal. They'll come up now in the Wildcat package.
Here we go! 3rd and 38! 3rd and 38!
Back to throw. And the trick play doesn't work. Good reaction there defensively, and it'll be 4th down.
And that was a nice play. He knocked it away, but obviously you want the interception in this situation. You want to take away any chance that they have any decision to make on fourth down. But things happen so quickly in the end zone in this compressed area of the field that you're just happy to knock it away and not allow a touchdown.
Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on fourth and goal. Gotta try it here. He's back. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Allen Robinson with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Jaguars are within an extra point of tying this one up. And no sweat. He puts it through, and we are tied here in the fourth. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. They get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play. But if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. Got a man over the middle and it's complete. A good pick up there, 22. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll be taken down right around the 41-yard line. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turn around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge? Whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end in the direction they want to run the football. If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a game. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play.
A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down. And now the Jags defense deciding to call a timeout. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. And they give this time to the tailback. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been...
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. So it all comes down... And now the Jags going to signal for another timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. So it all comes down here to the right foot of Randy Bullock. 2 seconds on the clock. This for the win. And his kick is good. He knocks through his 3rd field goal of the game, and this one is the one that decides it. And it'll be a hot time across the Cumberland tonight. The Titans have won it. And just a heck of a final drive that you and I just got to witness.
We got to see calm, cool, and collected in action, didn't we? That allowed them to go down the field and score the game-winning points.
So for Tennessee, their battle to finish 500 gets a slight lift as they move to 6-8 on the year. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Denver Broncos. Meanwhile, for the Jaguars, they'll drop to 10-4 on the year. And they'll look to get back on the beam next week as they host the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.